There we go. Sorry, I was trying to find the unmute button. Hello everyone. Welcome to today's Sonder Social. I'm so excited to have you join me. I know this Sunday kind of threw me off with the time change. So it's really exciting to all be together tonight. I am so excited. I see a lot of familiar names in the chat. I'm so super excited to see you all return. And if there's any new folks joining us for the first time, either it's your first social or your first weekly setup, go ahead and shout yourselves out. We are so excited to welcome newbies. Welcome, welcome. Amazing. Welcome, Rachel. So I'm very, very excited to have you join us and join the party. All right. So before we get started, because we do have some new folks, make sure to set your chat to everyone. The social does go kind of fast. There's a lot to a weekly setup, so we're going to get through it together, but it'll be very, very fun to just get everything ready for the week. And I'm Malika. I will be joining, I'll be leading you through your weekly setup this week. And I am joined by Jennifer Krippner, who is popping on to give you a big old wave. She will be manning the chat. So you'll see her pop in, answer any questions you might have. And yeah, and she's dialing in from Minnesota and I'm dialing in from San Francisco. So we're very, very excited. All right, let's dive in. So grab your March journals and grab something to write with, and we will get started. All right. And for just a disclaimer, we wanted to make sure that we reiterate our community guidelines, which includes being kind and courteous to yourself and others. No promotions or spam. Make sure to respect everyone's privacy. No hate speech or bullying. And make sure to limit any product and accessory questions or customer care inquiries to our hello at silkandsonder.com team. That's HQ. And just remember that Sonder socials are a time for all of us to connect with each other and get the most out of our journals, because I know I get a lot of inspiration from each and every one of you. So this will be fun to go in together and just kind of bounce ideas off of one another. As you can, you'll see in the slides, I get a lot of inspiration from Sonder fam. So thank you. All right. Okay, let's talk about momentum. So I did a lovely journaling social earlier this week, and I had a great time diving into momentum and really kind of unpacking what momentum means. So I want to kind of turn to page two in the journal, which is Meha's letter, and kind of I love that definition in the second paragraph, and I'll read it to you all. We're celebrating momentum, a force that propels us forward, igniting the spark of progress and change. So I think when it comes to momentum, it's a great kind of it's beautifully timed, just because with spring, we have a new season. Typically, spring is a transition period. So we're moving from the colder months to the warmer months. And I think with that, a lot of momentum is also within nature and all around us, and also within us. And so what we're going to do is we're going to kind of unpack what momentum means in our mind map, which will be our intro activity before we get into our weekly setup. So keep that in mind as we think about momentum and thinking about just that fuel that keeps you going. I will run us through the agenda. So we have the momentum mind map, which I just talked about. Then we'll go into Rosebud Thorn, and then we will go through all those fun weekly setup pages with all the fun sections. All right. Okay, so for this momentum mind map, typically if you're new to weekly setup socials, for each weekly setup social, we focus on a certain area of momentum or the theme of the month, and we create this sort of mind map. So we're on the second week, and it's totally fine if you missed a weekly setup last week. I'll show you the question for week one, and you can always come back to that. But we're gonna unpack the second dimension of momentum together. So for this section, if you've already created your momentum mind map from the last weekly setup, go ahead and turn to that. And if you're starting fresh, that's totally fine. Turn to a blank page for your momentum mind map. And for this week, we're going to focus on week two's question, which is, are there specific obstacles that hinder your forward movement? What are some personal tendencies or external factors that have slowed your development in specific areas? So this one is probably hard to think about, and it's not always fun to think of the negative, but it is important to recognize if we have any like self-limiting beliefs, or if there's anything that we tend to do that help that kind of hinders our movement forward. So how do we kind of think about what those obstacles are? And they can be something small, like maybe for me, I know I tend to be like a stickler. So if things aren't perfect, if I don't feel like in control of kind of the process, then I freak out and I feel like that's not a good path for me. And I think that is something that I'm working on. So try to think about what those obstacles are for you. Is there anything that helps you that kind of makes you feel like you're in a scarcity mindset instead of a growth mindset? Try to think about what those obstacles are that hinder your momentum. So I'll give you all a few minutes to reflect, and I already see some great chat. So if you feel compelled, definitely share in the chat with all of us, and we'll regroup in a few minutes. All right. Thank you all for sharing your blockers or whatever is hindering you from propelling forward. It's good to recognize kind of what's holding us back, just so that we can kind of work on that and make sure that we are keeping it in mind whenever we feel like we're not able to move forward. So thank you all so much for being so vulnerable in the chat. And we will now move on to Rosebud Thorn. So for Rosebud Thorn, this will be on page 36 of your journal. Sorry, let me change the slide. For Rosebud Thorn, you'll see it on the right of today's date. And for your Rosebud Thorn, for your rose, you want to write something that you're grateful, that's going well, something that you're grateful for, something that's a highlight of your week. A bud is a new and emerging opportunity, something that's new on the horizon. And then your thorn, is there something that is serving as a challenge currently or something that you've been struggling with? So thinking about kind of reflecting on the week and what has been working well, what hasn't been going so well. It's good to take inventory of what's going on. And also, if you're struggling to come up with the rose and you've been filling out the kind of highlight of my day page on page, what page is that? Oh, I think it's on, hold on. It's on page 18? Yes. No. Page 21. If you've been filling that out and you're struggling to think of a rose, that's a good place to turn to. As you can always kind of choose one of those as your rose. But yeah, think about what your rosebud thorn is. My rose from the last week is I'm really grateful for great girlfriends for always cheering me up, and it's been a stressful few weeks. My bud is I'm ready for my new chapter in my career, and my thorn is dealing with stress every morning at work. So I will now give you all some time to think about your rosebud thorn, and we'll regroup in a bit. All right. Thank you all for sharing your rosebud thorn. We will now move on to the weekly setup, which will be on page 40. So turn to page 40 and we'll go ahead and start off with the how I want to feel. So this week, I want to feel. And then here are some example words that I love that you can use as inspiration. So try to think about what that word is for you. Here are some examples. It doesn't have to be a word, it could be a phrase. Whatever that feeling is for you, think about what it is, and I want you to write it in the chat so we really set in our intention for the week. So thinking about how we want to feel, is there a certain feeling you want to feel? Is there a certain adjective? Is there a certain action? How do you want to feel this week? Go ahead and type it in the chat. Okay, we want to feel free, grounded, empowered, accomplished, friendship, productive, ready for it, connected, creative, vibrant, inspired, happy, organized, renewed, energetic, positive, seen, worthy, confident, in control, rested. I'm all right, unifying, optimistic, relieved of stress from work, lucky. These are all so such powerful words to set your intention for the week. So thank you all for kind of setting that intention, writing it down. We will now move on. Now that we've figured out what that word is for the week and how we want to feel, we'll now move on to the weekly major three goals. So the box just below how you want to feel, turn to just focus your attention on that box. And here are some examples of how you can structure your three goals. So you can definitely use that feeling that you've set your intention for the week as an inspiration for your goals. So here you see some examples of folks who said they wanted to feel energized, and then they applied that to their work, body, and mind, and made that their three goals. You can see that with the word celebrate. But you can also just make any three goals. If there's anything that you really, really want to focus on, that's something that you really want to accomplish for the week and have a little bit more as like an overarching goal for the week, definitely feel free to break away from that format. You can also repurpose this section you can put a quote there if you want to feel like you want some inspiration and you just want to repurpose this box. You can definitely do that. There's no right or wrong way. So I'll give you all some time to figure out what your three goals are. And feel free to share with us in the chat one or all three of your goals, and we'll regroup for the weekly to-do section next.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks for sharing your goals. And we will now move on to the next section, which is just to the left of this box, which is the weekly to-do section. So I'm going to walk us through a couple of different ways you can structure your to-do list. Obviously, a default is to write a bulleted list and check it off as you finish your tasks. But there are a couple of different ways that I'll walk us through on how to set up this section if you want an alternate format. So for the first concept is the Eisenhower matrix. So this helps you prioritize your to-dos, and you can kind of think about what is important, what's urgent, and what's not urgent. And this is kind of like the do, decide, delegate, and delete. So for example, in the delete column, you would have doom scrolling on TikTok, anything that's kind of taking away from your productivity or limiting social media between X amount or certain times of the day. Delegate would be any decisions that you can kind of just have put off to someone that can help decide or any decisions you need to make and that don't really have a deadline. And then do are things with clear deadlines, things that have to get done, and kind of like your top priority. So that is the Eisenhower matrix. You can also see some examples on the right. Mine is on the upper right, and that basically helps me categorize my to-dos in the different kind of areas of my life. So work, health goals, anything related to like whatever I was pursuing at the time. I wasn't taking a course at the time. So just kind of structuring it in that regard helps me kind of focus on what I need to get done. You can also see someone took this space to write out their to-dos for their physical, mental, and emotional health. So you can definitely do it that way. Another way is the need, want, hope to-do list. So if you're kind of feeling like you want to be a little bit more kind of dreamer oriented this week and you just want to write out your wish list in that format, you can definitely do that. You can see some an example in the bottom left that uses this format. And then you can also use this section. Maybe you want to focus on your routine this week. So, writing out things you want to do during your morning routine and your evening routine, especially with the time change, maybe that's a focus for you to feel like you're back in the zone given the shift. So, that can be used. And then you can also see some folks love a good bingo board to help like gamify their to-do list. So you can definitely cover it with a sticker or color it in with a marker, whatever it is to help you kind of finish off those tasks. And then another fan favorite, I know it's a fan favorite amongst some of the facilitators, is this notion of a to-do and ta-da list. So to-do is a to-do. A ta-da is basically anything that was a bit challenging that you got done that you want to give yourself credit for. So think of it almost like when you were in kindergarten and you got a gold star for something that you did. That ta-da is giving that yourself a little bit of recognition when you're going throughout your week and you're dealing with challenging tasks. So I love that concept too. The to-do to-do list is always a fun one as well. So I definitely rambled a ton, but I'll give you all a few minutes to set up your to-do list and we'll regroup for the habit and activity section next.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you all for taking the time to write out your to-dos. We will now move on to the habit and activity section. So for the habit and activity section, you can kind of think about what habits you want to track. So for me, typically these are health related. So either it's making sure I'm working out or thinking about my rest, making sure I'm getting enough sleep, going to bed early, maybe no alcohol, journaling on that in the evening or going outside for the day. I'm thinking about kind of what's going to help with my mental and physical wellness throughout the week. You can see some examples here. I love this one on the right where she fills in the number because she's tracking her weight fluctuations day to day. So you can definitely feel free if you want to write in the bubble, like, and start using this almost like as a metric tracker. You can definitely do that. I love that approach. I also love the use of kind of logging the fruits and veggies intake and kind of making it into almost like a pie chart each day. So that's definitely a great approach to, and a very creative approach. You can also see this one on the top put kind of the like a routine of what things they wanted to do maybe at night or in the morning, whatever it may be, and almost like kind of having that step by step, which is definitely a fun way to do it as well. Like say you want to switch up your night routine and you want to use this habit section almost like as a checkoff list. That's a cool way to use it as well. And if you're not feeling like you want to track any habits, you can. You don't have to use this section if you don't want to. And I think also keep in mind the goal. It's not your goal is just to help you stay on track, but you don't it's okay to not meet that goal. We're all human and it's important to give ourselves grace because life is unexpected and things come up. So just remember, you don't have to fill out every bubble. That's not the purpose of this. The purpose of this is to think about what those habits are for you and doing the best we can. So I will give you all a few minutes to fill out your habit and activity section, and let us know what habits you're tracking for the week, and then we'll move on to the meal plan section next.
Thank you.
Right. Thanks for sharing what habits you're tracking for the week. I am very excited for this week because I feel like I've been a little bit off my game. So it's nice to kind of start the week fresh and really just think about being intentional with my habits for the week. So thank you all for that. We will now move on to the next page. So page 41, and we'll walk through the meal plan. Okay, so full disclosure, this is a section that gets heavily, heavily repurposed. So I will walk through a few different ways you can set this up. I set this up differently each week, depending on what I want. You can definitely use it for a meal plan, which is its intended purpose, but you can also repurpose it. You can also use this as a food log too, which I've done before. So there's definitely fun ways to do it. And here you can just I'll just walk through the different ways. So you can use this section to write out your daily affirmation. I get my affirmations from the Silk & Sonder app every day. You can also use this as a section to just reflect. Maybe you like journal in the morning or journal at night, and you just kind of want to reflect on the day ahead or the day that's passed. You can also use the section to reflect on the seven types of rest, which is physical, mental, sensory, creative, emotional, social, and spiritual. So you can definitely use this section for that. You can also use a section. I love this example of a daunting chore. So cleaning the whole house is daunting, but maybe if we break it up zone by zone each day into bite-sized chunks, it becomes less of kind of a stressor in our life completing the chore. So you can definitely use it in that regard. For folks who are either going on vacation or maybe they are dressing up for work or dressing up for their day, you can use this section to plan out your outfits for each day of the week. You can also use the section to write out any appointments you might have or any special events that are going on. If you think that there's just a heavy week in terms of appointments and stuff like that, you can definitely use that section for that. You can also just use a section however you'd like. There's so many different ways to set this up. So I will give you all some time to set up your meal plan section, and then we'll regroup for the Mind Body Health Plan next. All right, we will now move on to the Mind Body Health Plan. So, for this section, you can really think about kind of what's going to help you feel like you're kind of at your best self. And if that's like identifying some treats to look forward to, maybe it's a workout plan that you want to stick to. Maybe it's kind of a different type of treat for each day. So I love the different ways you can do this. Maybe it's just right. Like I love this example with the stickers and doing a hot drink, eating vegetarian for a day, vegan for a day, extra time in the shower, just little things in your week that will be almost like a wellness treat. Something that I like to do for this section is kind of plan out, okay, when am I going to do kind of my face mask, or maybe I want to do an extra level of like facial treatment. I have all the fun products that you can think of. I have way too many. So I need to use those. So that's always fun. Or maybe it's spending 30 minutes kind of going to the sauna. I love kind of sitting in my sauna and just really getting a sweat in, especially during the colder months. And then also just spending some time outside, whatever it may be that helps you feel healthy. So I will give you all some time to set up your mind body health plan. And if you don't feel like writing out a mind body health plan, that's fine. You can repurpose this into a quote section. Maybe there's certain podcast episodes that you want to listen to this week. Or maybe there are certain things that you want to do for the week. I highly encourage you to make sure you tailor this to best serve you. So I'll give you all some time and then we'll regroup for the shopping list next.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you all for setting up your mind body health plan. I know everyone loves a little Dr. Dre, so I had to drop it for you all. But we will now move on to the next section, which is the shopping list section. So, again, this is a heavily repurposed section. You'll see like a ton of examples that I have from all of you. You can kind of see here, you can use this for a shopping list. Maybe there are a lot of things that you need to purchase, but you can also repurpose this and use this for setting some focused intentions. Maybe you want to have a bingo board. Maybe you want to put a quote in there. I love this calmness scale. I love that idea where you can kind of, if you're feeling like you're a little flustered, maybe you want to repurpose this section and kind of measure your calmness scale. So that is all fun ways to set up your shopping list. I see some folks like to put stickers in here. Some people like to put in a doodle section. That's always fun. Maybe you want to be more artistic. Maybe one of your goals was to be creative. So you can use a section to unleash that creativity. So this is a fun section. It's truly a blank box. So use it however you'd like to. I switch it up week to week. Sometimes I just want to put a big old quote sticker in there. Sometimes I just write out my, if I'm feeling like I'm bottling stuff in and I just need to free write, I just free write. There's so many ways to use this section. So I'll give you all some time to set up your shopping list section, however you want to use it this week. And then we will regroup together for the last little box, for the I am loving section before we close out. right. We will now move on to that last little section. We're nearing the end of our social. I know this hour goes by so fast. And I want you all to just take a deep breath, maybe roll your shoulders back. And if you would like to, close your eyes and really think about what you're currently loving in your life. I know we started off this hour by reflecting on our rosebud thorn for the week, but think about maybe something that you're truly loving. Maybe it's about yourself, maybe it's about something that's going on around you. Think about kind of those internal and external forces that are causing you to feel really excited or happy. So think about kind of what you're currently loving and share with us in the chat. I love this. Okay, Nicole is loving the students, loving the journey, making fancy affirmation cards for my family. I love that, Rev. And a sense of security, reading. Oh my gosh, there's so many great things. The chat's moving so fast. This community, spending the weekend with my kids. I love this, seeing my students' research come to fruition. I just love kind of getting a sense of your world. And I feel like when we think about what we love in each of our lives, it really dives into that meaning of Sonder, which is everyone has a complicated life, but is also deep and meaningful. And I love kind of getting a window into what is going well in your life. So thank you all so much for sharing. We are unfortunately at the end of the social, which I know I'm really sad about. I love spending this hour with you all, but just remember to share your weekly pages, with us. As you saw, all those examples I pulled, they're all from you. So please, please, please share if you have any kind of ideas of how you set this up and it worked really well for you. Definitely share in Sonder Club. You can also add it to the inspiration section of the app, which kind of focuses on the different areas. So you can upload it to those sections. That would be amazing. And also remember, we have our referral program going on. So if you love Silk and Sonder and there's someone close to you that might love it as well, make sure to take advantage of that referral program. You can also, if you're not already on the annual subscription, take a peek at that. You could be saving a ton of money. It's a great deal. And then also just remember that we have the survey. So if there's anything that you'd like to see, any programs that you'd like to see from all of us, we'd love to hear your ideas. Sonder Socials are a reflection of your feedback. So definitely let us know how we're doing, what you want to see more of, what you want to see less of. That's all really helpful for us. And then also we have the YouTube link that Jennifer put in the chat. So make sure to check that out. That's a private YouTube page for all of you. And just remember that the social will be there in a few days. So it takes a couple of days for it to be uploaded, but it will be there. And then before another thing that I wanted to share with you all, there is an event, a special event this week on Wednesday at 5 p.m. Pacific. And it's really exciting. It's with our CEO, Meha, who's also my sister. We're going to be exploring our Enneagram. So understanding ourselves and others is really exciting. I'm super excited. I will be there. I'm very excited to attend. So definitely check that out if you want to learn more about your Enneagram and understanding yourself on a deeper level. Make sure to check that out if you're free. And also, I have my playlist as heavily requested. I have so much fun playing all my music for you guys. You guys are the best. So thank you all for all the fun comments in the chat. I did see that. I saw all of it. But you can go ahead and scan that, and let me go ahead and pop the link in the chat as well if the scan is not working for you. Let me just go ahead and pop that. There we go. That is the link to the playlist. So go ahead and check that out. There's a ton of instrumentals in there. So yeah. All right. Well, thank you all so much for spending this hour with me and Jennifer. We have so much fun with all of you, and I hope that the Sundays are less scary now that you've set up your week. I will see you at my next social. Bye, everyone.
Like that, I'm your dream come true when it's on a platter for you. Then you pull back when I try to make plans more than 2 hours in advance. I slam the door, I hit ignore. I'm saying no, 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 no more. I got you blocked after this, an afterthought.
Sorry for your loss.
So much better.